Five emotes are well underway. It is on the way. So stand by. They're coming. You've already had five. There's another five coming. And then there's another five coming after that. Ascot's working on it. Apparently he's had post trip flu or whatever, something like that. So he's been a little bit ill, a bit slower than he usually would. But he's got me the drawings. They're looking good. And I've given him the all clear to go ahead and colour them up. Ascot's brilliant, man. He does such a good job on emotes. We're dealing with the static emotes, Reese. And then we'll take care of the animated. Will be an animated one. Yeah. So we're going to do all the static ones, get those replaced because they need to be done. And then we'll start adding animated ones. We'll have like, I'll get an actual character made somehow. Get that animated up. And we'll actually have a button. We'll have, you know, all sorts. Like a little salute for the train, maybe. Something like that. So, that's the plan. You need the button emotes coming emote for all the times we're told emotes are coming. I mean, look, I can't get Ascot to go any quicker than he already is, right? Like, it would be rude of me to be like, are they done yet? Have you done it yet? Please, can you get them done? Like, I just let him do his thing, right? There's nothing worse than somebody nagging you. Like, I could never draw anything close to something like that. So I can't pipe up and be like, why are they not done yet? Hurry up. I wouldn't have a Scooby's where to start drawing something like that. So I let him do his thing. He was away on his first trip in Vegas or something. That's why the first lot took so long. And then just as that trip was coming to an end, the second lot were getting done. Then it got ill. And now it should be in full swing. So hopefully I'll have those emotes by Monday. That'd be an ideal situation. So they are coming thick and fast, boys. Thick and fast. Now, the news. The emotes is part of the news. But is there any other news to talk about? The answer is no. Other than it is the weekend that is approaching. We are going for 261 on the streak today. Marathon show is this time next Friday. This time in a week's time. We'll be well underway into an 18-hour buttonathon. What else? Updates for the weekend shows. I'm not here Saturday or Sunday. I'm not here at all over the weekend. So I will be back on Monday. Me and Steph are away celebrating our 1 year somewhere. We couldn't do the thing we wanted to do last week. So we did it for this weekend. So we're going to be away celebrating that. But we'll be back on Monday. You'll have me Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, possibly Thursday. And then Friday is marathon show. So that's the planooski. Your sub's got rip. It's okay. Don't worry. Look, who knows? You know, sometimes the occasional sub bomb comes in. Somebody drops five subs or something like that. Who knows? Maybe you'll get lucky and get one. Because it does prioritize people who are in the channel frequently and hang out a lot. But so hopefully you'll grab one if that happens. So don't panic. It'll be okay. Pretty soon after the marathon, it'll be 269 if the streak continues. We'll see. We'll see. Yesterday was a brilliant day. And hopefully today we'll be able to also smash the streak. So without further ado, let's do some hellos. If you're out there, you're not lurking in the darkness, please say hello in the chat. I shall say hello back. We should welcome everybody to the show. We're doing some vanilla today. Modded will be back on Monday. And yeah, it's going to be great. Looking forward to it. I don't think there's anything else to talk about. There was something else I feel like I had to say, but... Oh, United! Where's Liam? Is he in here yet? Can't wait to shit on him. Reese will do. He's a Liverpool fan. United! 2-0. Have some of that. How do you like them apples? Well, good morning, Rubber Duck. How are you? MKL, good to see you. Rhythm, Mischievous, Smeety, good to see you. Ayla, Twitch Shells, good morning to you. Dr. Laiku. Is that Dr. Lively? Good to see you. Reese with the C's, Akona, DJ Sweetmix, Knight of Winters, how are you? Don, DJ, Kareen, good to see you. Jimmy, Kate Holes, good morning to you. Hopefully you guys are doing well. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Can you shout really loudly when you go near the pagodas to put a name? Can you shout really loudly when you go near the pagodas to put a name on it? I haven't seen them fully or how you add the names. I'll tell you what we'll do, Speedy. We'll do it as soon as we log in. I'll show you that I don't have to shout. I'm trying to preserve my voice and protect it because in a week's time we have an 18-hour show to do. So I'm not going to be shouting. However, we will. I will happily show you them as soon as we log in. All right. Sound like a plan? I did go to the pub yesterday. Ended up having about 7 pints in the end. So I don't feel full of energy this morning, but we power through anyway. You know, a couple of beers, 7's about right. That works out about right. An odd number, Eel, I know. I did think that at the time. I was like, should I have one more? And I was like, no, just go home, Jack. Go home. So I made a responsible decision. So I was like, I'll feel shit tomorrow, and it's just not worth it. 1, 2, 3. Oh, no, I had 6 pints. Never mind. I had 6. I thought I had 7. I had 6. There we go. A little delicate? I wouldn't say delicate. I feel all right. That was the idea. The plan is I didn't want to feel like shit. And I felt a bit blech this morning, but I'm all right. Been out to Carter for a walk. Feel good. We're chilling. Anyway, let's play some games. And that'll be me done, really, with the pub until... Well, it'll be a couple weeks now. Be a couple weeks. All right. Let me do my beard up here so it's all fresh. I'm glad I'm not the only one, Don, that has that can't really end the night on an odd number. Excuse me, we'll be having drinks tomorrow. I'm not drinking alone. Yeah, we will. I said it'll be the last time I'm in the pub for a while. Tomorrow, I won't be in a pub. You still forget we're top of the Prem and UCL, so there. Okay, well, we'll take a look in April how that's going for you. And when you finish the season trophyless, we will all laugh. How about that? How about that? Okay, so first of all, let's grab a few... No, let's do Smeety's thing, and then we'll get more fireworks. Smeety! Are you here? I've had a bit nasally. Yeah, I need to get a... I need to get an allergy test done, because every time I drink, the next day, my nose is fucked. It's always running... and like stuffy and horrible, and I just don't know why. So I don't know if there's like some sort of, and I sneeze a lot and stuff like that, so I don't know if there's like I'm slightly allergic to, I don't know, wheat or something, or, I don't know. So I need to get that done. So these are the pagodas, Smeety. They've got multiple floors. We're going to add a spiral staircase going up when we need to, but as you can see, we've got the all the channel points people in here, who get a birch shine with their name on it. Reed Reese's bet. Okay, 1 second. Hold on. An Enderman appears to have put this up here for me. But this is the red pagoda, which has the single name glowing red signs in here. This is 10,000 bits or 20 subs. And then we have the blue one, which is all blue glass in the middle, which I'm too high up. They're down there. But there's 2 names per sign. Ah, oh, fuck it. I'll go down. I'll go down. But in blue, there's 2 names per sign, and they're all glowing gloriously on the spruce signs. And then in the green section is non-glowing, but they're all on dark oak signs. There's 4 names to a sign. And there you have it. And these are the pagodas. So anybody who supports the show whilst we're on the vanilla world, !monument, I think is the one in the channel, or !pagoda, we'll get into one of these. Morning, Aussies girls. It's never too late for a morning. Good morning, Liam. Liam United. 2-0. Have some of that. Have some of that. No, I've started him off now. I can't be arsed. Fuck that. I'll put a tier 3 sub up that we won't end trophyless. So if you... Okay. So if Liverpool finish the season and haven't won a trophy, I will give You will give the chat a tier 3 sub. And if they have won a trophy, I'll give chat a tier 3 sub. Is that your proposition? Morning, Georgia. How are you? Did you see the ultimate irony last night button? The ultimate irony. I don't think I did. By the way, I did a little bit of a test yesterday, chat. I made a YouTube short and a TikTok. And I uploaded it. And I didn't tell anybody. I didn't tweet anything. Because I was just curious what sort of numbers it would do. We've gained 2 new subs on YouTube. And the YouTube short I posted, without me telling anybody, got 1,600 views. Tough time never lasts. Only tough people last. They got 1,600 views on YouTube, which I'm kind of stoked about. So there's going to be a lot more of that coming. I don't know what it did on actual TikTok. I haven't looked. Only 404. But still, given the fact I told nobody, I'll take that. Chelsea beat a team called No Resistance 8-0. Is that what the final score was? I saw it was 6-0 in the first half. God, could you imagine your team playing in the Conference League, lol? Couldn't be me. Should have been me. But we won the FA Cup. United. Tom, thank you, mate. Let me get my calculator up, because I need to make sure we add these bits up for Tangier. By the way, news on that, which I found out, there is no way of the Twitch API doesn't support bits used on Tangier to be able to add to the bar and stuff automatically. There's no way to do it. So that's a bit fucking shit, but I'm going to add them up manually and we'll add them at the end of the show onto the bit bar. Should we need to. We might even get the fucking bit goal without it, so we'll see. But yeah, it's a Twitch thing, so maybe someday they'll support it. But it's nothing to do with Superfrost. Damn it. Button, my bet was that if the loser gives a tier 3 sub to the winner. But I can't get you a tier 3 sub because you're already subbed. And you can't give me a tier 3 sub because I'm the broadcaster. So my negotiated terms will be to the community. Someone in the community can have a tier 3 sub. Give it some more. Like, to be honest, if Chelsea don't win the Conference League, it's... There's a serious issue with it. Right, 2 stacks of this. Come on. Fair. Done. Can't wait for you to win nothing. It's going to be great, man. It's going to be great. That'll do it. That's all we needed. No, I was going to say, there's not really any string we can take in here. Alright, we'll just quickly kill these guys. God, no! Fucking no! Babe! Hold on, you have a creeper farm. Yeah, but it's terrible. It's stupidly slow. And it's no good. We need something big, and that just makes thousands of gunpowder a minute. That's what we need. Steph, this could be the end of us, actually, if this continues. Just so you're aware. There needs to be a fast change to being a United supporter, or there's going to be issues. So we're going to get you to a game. Going to get you watching more games on the telly. The quadruple, I wear a Liverpool kit on the screen. If Liverpool win the quadruple, I will wear a Liverpool shirt on the screen, on the stream for a day, sure. But you have to pay for it, because I would never spend money on that dirt. That's a done deal. That's how confident I am that it would never happen. We can watch Sunday inside of the sports bar. Is there a sports bar? No way. Fuck everything else. Go to the sports bar. Hell yeah. You can enjoy everything else. I'm not bothered. You'll see me. I'll be in the sports bar. There's everything. Okay, I don't know what to expect. I really don't. Right, hold on. Let me have a look when United play. I believe it is Sunday. Sunday at 2 o'clock. Wowie. Absolutely. I will be in the sports bar watching United. Shake on it. What happens the other way around, Liam? What if Liverpool don't win the quadruple? Because there has to be... It's not just a one-way thing, because it's just a lose-lose for me, isn't it? I don't gain anything. So there has to be something on your part put up here. Like, you, if you don't win the quadruple, you have to buy a United kit, wear it, and send me a picture in Discord. Something like that. Something like that. Or... You have to admit in the chat, with no cappers or anything like that, the Manchester United are the greatest team in the world. Can't wait for winter, chat. It's going to be great. When it gets real cold in February time, I can put on my Manchester United beanie. Oh, yeah. It's going to be great. That would be lying. Incorrect. Incorrect. We need to deal with this as well. This is far too dark. We'll have to build up with Nether and just whack some torches on here because I don't want this to be like not lit up. But yesterday, we did a lot. We built this whole bottom section of TNT yesterday. We did all of this up the sides, everything. And it looks phenomenal. Super stoked about this. Let me pull up the thingy-majig here because I think we'll get close to... There we go. I think we'll get close to finishing this today. Downloads, screenshots. Pulling up this TNT build so I can see what I was doing. Right. Do you not have any club songs? Of course we do. We have many. Oh. Maybe I could have a video of you singing Glory, Glory, Man United. Oh, dear. A video of them in a Liverpool bar with a Man United kit singing club songs. Johnny, look, I'm all for a punishment and a bit of fun, but I don't want Liam to be literally killed. Right? I would probably go down for murder if I made him do that. Okay. Let's just pop this in here for a sec. We need a bit more food. A little bit more food. Oh, we fucking ran out of gravel. That's what I remember now. Right, we're gonna have to go get some gravel and sand, chat. Get hype. Hi! What about glowstone or sea lanterns in the floor of the third TNT block? It might help a little bit, Em, but I don't think the... I mean, I... No, it's not that I don't think. The light won't travel far enough down the block, so... Fuck you, Jerry. So if you win the quadruple, I'll wear a United... a Liverpool kit. That's a shirt on screen. But if you... No, sorry. If you do win the quadruple, I'll wear a Liverpool shirt on screen. And if you don't win the quadruple, you and Reese have to give 20 subs. I mean, yeah, done. I would fucking do that all day long. All day long. I don't think Reese will accept that. But I will happily. Happily. That's just a free 20 subs from both of you. There's no chance you win a quadruple. You can wear it for a marathon stream. God, couldn't think of anything worse. Hi, Fatty Burp. How are you? There's talk of Matt's community getting a bit... They're getting a bit ahead of themselves. And they think they're going to win this year in the Hype Train competition. And there's talk that if they do win... I don't even want to say it. It makes me want to fucking throw up. There's talk that if they do win, I have to wear a Man City top on stream. God, man. We can't... God. Fuck. Honestly, that... That would be fucking terrible. Am I a Wolves fan? No way. That level 10 will get beaten at some point because it is beatable. But as long as we win this month, we're okay. We're still in the game. That's the spiders. Cool. Let me go grab some sand. So I haven't bought a kit in 3 years. I like to buy kits. I do. I mean, eventually I'm going to have like 100 United tops. But I do like buying the kit. Only if it's good. Last season. Was it last? Yeah, I think it was last season. The away and the third kit were just horrible. I hated them.
And his name is me, Trixon!
That bar speed is way better now. Way better.
One sign, please.
Smeedy, we will get you a sign, bud. Thank you very much. Coming in with the 1,500 biddies. Kicking off the day. Thank you, mate. Hooray! Shit! Hooray! My word. Dear Lord. Hooray!
One more sign,
Speedy taking the number 2 spot on the leaderboard with a fucking bomb of 5,000 biddies and 1,500 biddies, getting himself a green and a glowing blue sock. What the fuck? Speedy! Oh my god!
Your instructions are too complicated. I don't know how to get into all 4 pagodas.
You're insane, Speedy. What the fuck, mate? Thank you very, very much.
This needs a train.
Holy crap. Well, Speedy's now got himself a green, glowing blue, and personal glowing red sign. Speedy, thank you very, very much, man. Really do appreciate it.
Might as well hype train this shit.
Speedy, get you a glowing blue sign. You already have a glowing blue sign. And of course, a glowing red one as well. You're on the list. We got you. Wow, mate, you're fucking insane. I'm Don with the 200 bits. Johnny with the 200 bits. Taking us a level 7 hype train. Dear Lord. Chat, can we get a huge wall of hearts up for all the guys dropping love? Especially Smeedy dropping a fucking bomb.
Smearty, you're seriously one insane peep. Glue hype button hype.
Crazy. Thank you, Oakhill, for the 300 biddies. Really do appreciate that. Taking the number 1 spot on the leaderboard. Dethroning Adam. Crazy. Thank you very much, Smearty. You're far too kind, mate. Thank you. Yeah, there's 4. So the other one is channel points. Yeah, the other one is channel points. I don't know if we ever did conclude what we were going to do for in the very, very rare chance that somebody gets a gold sign of where we were going to put it or what we were going to do for it. I can't remember. I mean, we'll worry about that if that occurs, but... I know we mentioned that we were going to do something for it. I just can't remember what it was. Fizzy wants in on the monument. We got you. You came out the other day. So you have... Yeah, I see it here. You have every single sign possible other than the gold ones. Boom. Thank you, Smeedy. What a legend, pal. Really do appreciate that. Thank you. Whoops. There we go. That was not a whoops button. It's totally fine. Build an entire pagoda. Their personal pagoda. Can you imagine? We'll have to think of what we'll do for that, because we can't just slap a gold sign and... I mean, I don't know what we'd do. I don't know. We'd have to have a think. It'd have to be something crazy, but... A mini pagoda. We can't do mini pagoda. I wouldn't even know how to do a mini pagoda. It has to be the normal size one. Two minutes, 20 seconds left on the train, folks, if you want to get yourself one of the hype train emoticons. What are the gold ones? So gold is 100,000 bits in a single message, or 200 gifted subs, like back to back. Because you can only do a max of 100 subs at a time. So if somebody did 100, then another 100 straight away. That would also comply. Oh, I didn't bring my fucking bed. Luckily, there's a village over here. I'll go to sleep over that one. Tweedy, you're absolutely insane, mate. Thank you very, very much. You've no idea how much that helps out, pal, for real. Thank you. What a legend. Absolute legend. Thank you all as well for the biddies in between there as well. Really do appreciate it. I wish I could explain to you how much they help, but it's a crazy amount, so thank you. Let me head over here. I need... and bed. I wouldn't even know how to do a mini pagoda. Like, we do the big ones, but the big ones, like, are easy because it's just the block after block. It's just block after block, but the mini ones, I wouldn't have any idea at all how to shrink it down. Like, not a Scooby. I don't know, Swash. I don't know. I'm not sure where I've put it. It's probably in one of the... Oh, no. It'll be by the TNT. Chat, 30 seconds left on the train. Let's salute that. It is out of here. Level 7. 4 subs to save it, but I think it's too late. Only 25 seconds remaining. That is one hell of a train. Thank you very, very much. Again, for all the support, and Speedy for the bombs. Absolutely crazy. Oh, God, buddy! Oh, God! Oh, shit. He's dead. He killed himself. Oh, you're probably right, Em. Yeah, I bet I did. That sounds about right. That sounds about right. Well, oh shit, update the streak. Hold on, we're going to update the streak. Button moves, button, yes, button, hooray's in the chat. The streak has been hit. Hooray! There it is. 261. Hooray! Oh, it's not every day you see a fucking 10k bit bomb, chat. Dear Lord. Whoa, what is that, a hype train emote? What the fuck? Do I have that emote? I do. Since when was that an emote on the train? I don't remember that one. What about like a Tory gate next to the pagodas with a sign for the gold tier? Oh, do like a golden... A bunch of love there from Dom. Thank you, Dom. Appreciate it. I don't remember that kitty love being an emote. Although they've not updated him in forever, so I've probably forgotten. I'm hoping they'll do something for Christmas. We are due a new set. We are due a new set. Yeah, a Tory gate's not a bad idea. Perfect chance to hide next time that Tangier thing happens. Joe, I have considered doing something like that. Because I can just do this, and I vanish. And then chat and be like, what the fuck? Where's he go? But I have come into a problem that my stream deck is not big enough, and I need a stream deck XL. I did also think of that when I read it initially. I was like, oh god. I bet that was fucking Nightwolf. It was. Oh god, I genuinely just shit myself. What a shit bloke. Thank you, Nightwolf. And Nightwolf wonders why he gets the abuse that he does. Face cam is slightly not on the edge. Okay. I'm pretty sure it is. Oh shit, look at that. You're right. The microphone is floating. Sorry, is it ruining your immersion, Plasma? One second, I'll fix it. Did that do it? Nope. How's that? How's that? Yeah, that falling pipe one is fucking loud. I think that might have been Don. Yep, yes it was. Of course it was. Thank you, Don. Oh! That's what I meant to tell chat. Last night, I turned up all of the Tangier text-to-speech because they're all a bit quiet. So they've all been turned up now, so the volume of them should be far better. So if you ask AI a question or use one of the text-to-speeches on there, it will be hopefully the correct volume. I've not actually tested it, so hopefully it'll be the correct volume. Perfect example for the shadow. Perfect. Except for the shadow to your right. Yeah, there's nothing I can do about that. It's, unless I need to have a move around of my setup, really, because this light here is sort of being blocked by this monitor, which is why that shadow appears. But it's only like being half blocked. So I don't really know the solution, to be honest with you. A bit funny. I'm contemplating how I'm going to tweak this setup a little bit. Because I could always put that screen over here, but then it's sort of, I don't know. I don't know. I like it there because it's just out of the way. Because you don't really, the streaming PC monitor is used sometimes, but not massively often. Right, we'll get two shulker boxes and that'll do us. But like, especially if I'm working here and I'm not live. Like, I don't want it here. Like, not sure if you need to hear this, especially after beers yesterday, but I'm off to get a KFC now. Oh. I had a KFC the other day, and it was fucking beautiful. Oh, yes. Damn it! Now I want a KFC. Look what's happened. Speedy. I'm actually salivating. You just made me salivate. I could demolish a KFC right now. A nice little Colonel's three-piece meal. Well, by the rules of the channel, you know, Smeedy has brought up KFC, and anybody that is now hungry for a KFC, Smeedy now must buy a KFC. So if you are now hungry, chat, and want a KFC, please raise your hand, and Smeedy must buy you one. It's the rule. Let's see how many KFCs Smeedy owes. 14 KFCs, 15, 16 KFCs. When did that rule come in? That's been a rule for years. Don't try and get out of this now, Smeedy. You fucked it. It's too late, bud. Unfortunately, you flexed a KFC instead of a salad. You probably wouldn't have had as many people pipe up if you'd mentioned salad. Said your McDonald's has gone downhill. Yeah, some of them are a bit weird. Mine's still really good, luckily. But the one near Steph's is... like, it almost has, like, a chemically taste to it. It's fucking... it's not great. In, like, their chicken burgers. And... I'm not a big fan. So, KFC is my go-to. And if somebody said to me, Button, you could only have one for the rest of your life, KFC or McDonald's, it would be KFC. Like, it's just so good. I don't know how people just don't love it. I'd eat there every day if it was healthy enough. Like, their rice box is a banging. Then you can get, like, a fucking boneless banquet or a... just, like, a Colonel's piecemeal. It's just brilliant, man. Red Rooster's better. Stop talking about Red Rooster, Dom. I miss Red Rooster. Fuck me, what a place. Hopefully they branch out to the UK someday. What a place. I don't know why so many of you Aussies hate it. I just don't get it. It's unbelievable. Domino's would be your one takeaway. I do like a pizza night, but I just KFC is just there for you. Whether you're hungover, you just fancy a treat, whether it's just a quick lunchtime snack or a full dinner. Like, KFC's always there for you. You know, Domino's, you can't... I mean, I guess you could get a Domino's for lunch. Just get a small one. Maybe. Did you come back to the Oz just to have a Red Rooster? It's the only reason. Fly in, have a Red Rooster, leave. That doesn't sound the most... environmentally friendly trip. I flew to the other side of the world to eat chicken. Make for a banger of a YouTube video. Leftover Domino's for breakfast too. You're right. Do you know what? Right, I'm going to say this. There's probably going to get some hate, but I'm prepared to just take it. Right? Domino's is great. And you eat the pizza the night before. But in the morning... you know, usually you overdo the pizza and you feel bloated and blah. But you then do the same in the morning. You heat the pizza up. You're like, ladder, sure, whatever. You heat the pizza up. And then you're like, you eat it. But it doesn't hit the same because you had it yesterday. Like, you had it yesterday, so it doesn't hit the same as it did when you first had it last night. And you're eating it. And it's nice, but it doesn't have that euphoric... feeling when you bite into it. Fake cheese, your opinions are not valid. That's just fucking mean. Button, do you turn off all of your alerts and sound things when you end the stream, or are you one of those guys that just leaves it on? Totally not wondering if I can redeem falling pipe at like 7 in the evening and scare the shit out of you. No, I would never do that, not me. So the answer to your question is sometimes. If I'm doing something on the streaming PC... especially like a couple days ago, setting up this TikTok clip thing, then yes, all alerts and everything are active. And you could, in theory, claim falling pipe and it would scare the shit out of me, yes. My local Red Rooster always looks a bit dodgy in the cleanliness department, although I have it elsewhere and it's good. I mean, at the end of the day, Aussie Melly, it's always, and I've found this, it's the dodgiest chicken places that are the best. Right? When I've had trips to London, this used to be a bit of a theme when like a Twitch London event was going on or something. We'd go out, have beers, whatever. Go to the event. Then in the evening, I'd go to my hotel room and I'd go on Deliveroo and I'll find the dodgiest sounding chicken shop on the whole app and I'll order from it. And every time, it was just unbelievable. And I'm sure being pissed probably adds to it slightly as well, but every single time, it was just insane. Absolutely insane. I'll tell you what, we'll just fly over there. I was going to go back to the portal, but I'll just fly over here. And every single time it was insane. Like, something called fucking King Chicken or some shit. Oh, man. Unbelievable. Tom, thank you for the 100 bits. Because he said, how dare he. Wow. That was actually quite funny. But thank you for paying the fine, Tom. It's appreciated. Ducky wants a day with the Pagodas. You live on the edge button. Lucky you didn't spend the rest of the trip on the toilet. I mean, the way I see it, if you have a chicken shop that's running in London, first of all, you're not paying a penny of tax. But second of all, you still have upkeeping costs, right? And London is not cheap to do that. So it must be half decent and people buy from it, else it wouldn't exist. Like a bad restaurant or place to eat in London can't really exist. Because no one would go there because there's so many other options. So, we got you, Aussie Melly. Oh, I spelled your name wrong. Aussie underscore Melly. There we go. So yeah, like you, like so many people have to, well, must eat there because if it was shit, they just wouldn't go. Just got a Domino's notification. They're listening, probably. Probably. There's a ton of dog shit takeaways near me that nobody ever has seen to go in. The answer is money laundering. But do you live in central London? No. There's loads of street meat places now in London. I was in Blackfriars yesterday and the amount of doors in walls under bridges with a guy in an apron slapping meat in a wrap. I lost count. The queues for it. Jeez, must be good. You're absolutely spot on. There are so many hidden gems in London. Like down to some random street. There'll be some worldy of a food place. There's a great market. I don't know what it's called. You've obviously got your borough markets and your Camden markets. But there's a great market in Waterloo. And it's... You wouldn't know it was there unless you sort of peeked around the edge. And went over this bridge around the corner. But when you go up these stairs... I don't know how to describe it. There's like a little squared concrete thing. And then there's a market there around Christmas time. And there's probably 20 stalls there, all food places, like making this food, and it's ram. And there's dessert places, there's like Chinese, Indian, Thai, everything you can imagine. And it's just phenomenal. It's unbelievable. Steak and chips, chicken and chips. It's so good. They shut down for serving pigeon. That's quite funny. Now there's your mistake, Liam. You trusted a place that claimed to be perfect. Never trust a place that claims to be perfect. This place, for example, hold on, I had about 10 people lined up. Yeah, that's what I mean. It's shit like that. It's just crazy. I don't know if I can pull this up without it like showing my address. Google Street View seems really fucking dodgy. Actually, let's go to the London Eye. So I can probably direct you here. Uh, Is it that there?
Yeah, it is.
I don't know if I can pull this on screen. I'm really worried it'll fucking pull my address up. So this is one for you, Smeety, in the future. I'm going to assume it's going to be okay. I don't see anything relating to my address up here, so. Right. So this is the London Eye, right? Here's your London Eye in London. If you walk down the river and cross the bridge up here, or you can go down the road here. And you keep going. A little bit further along. All right, here's the railway bridge. Right. You go underneath this bridge. This concrete square here has a little market on it with about 20 stalls. And it's the most unbelievable food. They've got like a beer place at the back. And then all of this is just like food stalls with like desserts. All your different, you know, Indian Thai. Like, just incredible. Chicken steak. This is the bridge you can come over from the river. If you're ever in that sort of area of London, go to that market. I believe it's only on from like November, start of November through to like end of December. But it's just phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. And me, Matt and Kev always go there when we do the London Christmas trip because it's just insane. Like, you get steak, chips, chimichurri. Oh. Oh! Yes, please. Yes! Have you been to that one, Buster? Oh, mate, so good. It's a tiny little market, but it's just brilliant. No, they do it every year. Every year, from November through to December, there's a market there. I think sometimes in the middle of the year there is too, but I don't really know the dates of that. But I know the Christmas one's always there, and it's just phenomenal. Yeah, that's a great recommendation. Yeah, see? There's evidence that Buster has been. It's that good, man. It's a great place. But you can also walk along the river and go back over the bridge, because sometimes there's some stores, especially around Christmas, along the river as well. And you can go back over that bridge, and then you end up in that little food court. Oh, it's just so good. Ah! I can't tell you how hungry I am right now, for fuck's sake. I had shitty granola and coconut yogurt for breakfast. And now I just want... Oh, I'd be so fat if I lived in London. I'd be fat and poor. My God. Leo Lane, 14 months. Thank you, mate. I appreciate you, pal. Welcome back. Thanks, sir. How are we? Bum 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 ba da ba da bum bum ba ba da. Okay, we should go get a little bit of gravel, which I think we've been doing in the Nether, haven't we? God, I wish we could just find a gravelly hills. Should we try, chat? Should we try and find a gravel hills? Let me go get my bed as well. I'm gonna need that. A gravelly hill is just gonna be way easier than the Nether if we can find one. Wait, what were you looking for, Liam? Oh man, I really want to go to London just to go to that food market, man. Fuck me, it's so good. So good. Do, do, do. You know, London is just fucking shit. But places like that just make it so worth it. So worth it, I mean. Because it's so many gems. So many gems. Why is it if you gift more subs than there are viewers? Why is there a pig in my bed? Pig! What's happened? How have you ended up in here?
We are experiencing technical difficulties. Please stay tuned.
Are we all clear? Oh, okay, we're all clear. Great. All right, hit the red button.
No, not that button! Thank you, Tom. Thank you.
You go to London this year, mate, check out those markets. They're so good. If more... Hold on. Let me take Noisy and I'll answer your question, Kelly. Noisy! 30 months in a row.
Afternoon, lovelies, butt and heart.
Good to see you, Noisy. Hope you're doing well. Thanking you. Yeah, so if there's more... So the way it works is... it will prioritize people who are in the channel, right? That, like, there's a higher chance of people who are actually in the channel getting one. And then it'll prioritize people who follow the channel. And have sort of been around recently. And then it'll prioritize people who haven't watched the channel but just followed. And then it'll prioritize everybody on Twitch. So unless you gift, I don't know how many users are on Twitch, but like 100 million subscribers. Hey, here's a bit of Gravity Mountain. I'll do. Unless you gift like 100 million subscribers to cover every single account ever made on Twitch, then I don't know what would happen in that scenario. Start working tonight. No worries, Rosie. Have fun. Have fun. Now, I wonder what would happen if every single person took the sub to a channel and you tried to gift subs. I wonder if it just error out. Oh, Buster! How's Up Vember going, buddy? Still creeping up. I had a couple stocks that crept a little bit higher yesterday as well. It was a beautiful day. It was a beautiful day. The next 2 or 3 weeks, man. Oh, my God. The next 2 or 3 weeks is going to be beautiful. Beautiful. Hang on, nobody. Although what does make me laugh is if you look at the Google trends of the amount of people searching, like Bitcoin, for example, how all of a sudden, as soon as it's all going up to the moon, everybody's fucking searching it and trying to buy it and shit like that. And it's like, why have you not, like, realized previously that this is an asset class you should probably consider researching rather than trying to FOMO pile in when it's too late, you know? You're up 25% in the last 30 days. Boom. Good shit, man. Good shit. I don't know what I'm up in just crypto stuff. I think it's about 40% in the last 30 days. I'd have to have a look. Have a look. That's exactly why I don't bother with fucking pension funds or anything like that. Because that money is far better being invested elsewhere. Bye, bye. Okay. But it is, of course, each their own with things like that. A moonlit road. But something I did do as well, Buster, is when I sold my Tesla, I put a large portion of the money from that into investments. And so the money that the car depreciated in the 18 months that I had it has all been made back now. Oh, feels good, man. Feels good. It's all been made back. Almost. Not quite. Almost. Which feels good, man. Which means the whole time I had the car, it was free. It didn't cost me anything. But my words, button, one day I'll give 200 subs to your channel. And thank you for the free of charity you can be on shares. And for the beautiful community we have. Ah, I mean, that's always appreciated, but please never feel like you need to monetarily contribute to the channel. The number one way to support the show has always been, and will always be, just to be here. So, you're already smashing that out of the park, Kelly, and we appreciate you. Go, man. Basically, a company gave me a Tesla to piss around in now for 18 months. I had some fun, gave it back, and didn't lose anything. Business. What is it? Stonks. 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 Where's the stonks meme when I need it? Okay. I'm trying to set big goals for spending money in the future, so I have enough to motivate. I have enough motivation to earn it in the first place. I mean, whoops. Can I turn this off? Yeah, I mean, there's different people are motivated by different things. Some people aren't really motivated by money, or just happy to live paycheck to paycheck. But having sort of a goal, like my goal, for example, is to give Steph the best life possible, give my kids the best life possible, and give them a hopefully comfortable life. And in order for me to do that, you know, that's why I spent the last nearly five years learning, investing, researching, investing, to try and build a portfolio that someday will be a significant amount of money that, you know, can give them the best life imaginable. So that's the ultimate goal, and it will take years and years and years to get there. Maybe 20, 30 more years. But I'm determined to do it because that's what I want to do. But I'm also the kind of guy where, as much as I want to give them the best life possible, for me personally, I'd quite happily live a paycheck life. I wouldn't be asked. So, that's a mental battle you've got to fight. Like, that is a bit of a mental battle. Okay. Bum, 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 bum. If United win anything this year, I'm banning myself. Listen. United will win something this year. Ah, chat, I can't lie. I've not moved on from Smeety's comment earlier. I really, really want a KFC. Fuck's sake. Smeety! Look what you've done, man. I'm on a diet at the moment. I'm trying to lose weight before Christmas. Can we have a bit of a hype trade? Smeety decided he wanted one of every sign in the pagodas. So did 1,500 bits, 5,000 bits, and 10,000. I'm like, there we go. There's every sign. My question would be, is giving someone the best life possible simply being financially well off or making the most of what you already have? I think it's a bit of both. I think it's a bit of both, yeah. You know, I don't think money solves everything. I think there is also more to it. However, it definitely helps. It definitely helps. And I certainly wouldn't want my kids being brought up in a spoiled manner where they take everything for granted and don't appreciate what they have. So that's also a fine line to tread. If you had a shitload of money, had some kids, and were just like, right, here's an iPhone. Dad, can I have an iPad? Yeah, there you go. Can I have a laptop? There you go. Can I have an Xbox? Yeah. Right. I think that would lead to an unappreciated attitude. But to be able to say, you know, kids, you've done really well in school, let me take you to Disneyland, something like that. And just being able to not snap your fingers and be like, oh, we'll do it. But to be like, not like, shit, I got to save up for years and years. Just to be able to comfortably be like, we can probably do that. Budget it out and just go, yeah, we can do it. Like, that would be great. And through that, you'd make some unbelievable memories and things like that. It's always important to remember, no matter what your pursuit of happiness is, no amount of money ever bought a single second of time. I would dispute that. You know, private healthcare, for example, costs money. It's very expensive. But treatments can be a lot more effective. Like if you have a tumour or something, they can test that tumour against loads and loads of different chemotherapies and give you the perfect one for that specific tumour versus just giving you a chemotherapy that they think will be the best. So that in a way can buy time. But I do get what you're saying. True. You'd have to clean the house because you could pay for somebody to come and clean it. True. So in a way it does. But I get what Liam's trying to say. Oh shit. I filled that up already. Well, that was easy. Okay. How did I not know this was all here before, by the way? Like, also, I would have just come in from the start. The clean is the dream would be great, wouldn't it? Ideally, I'd like a cleaner and a chef. But to do that, you know, you're going to be paying your chef like 50 grand a year or something like that. Plus having to buy all the food and ingredients. So you're going to need a shitload of money to be able to do that. But that would be an absolute dream. Gordon on speed dial. Sometimes, though, the best feelings come from spending money that you don't have. I mean, that's very true. I have made decisions to do stuff that I probably shouldn't have done because I couldn't financially afford it. And it's been great. The problem is that then has a knock-on effect to later down the line and you're like, fuck, shouldn't have done that. That's made everything worse. So yes and no. Do I have a text back? Yes, it's called Fancy Skies. Thank you, Tall Paul, for the clean the stream. Appreciate it, mate. You couldn't care less about a chef? Oh, it'd be so good if you had a chef. I hate cooking. It'd just be terrible. You could have this guy make you proper, proper meals every day. It'd be mental. Is that a reality that's ever going to happen? Probably not, you know, unless I won the fucking lottery. But it'd be mega. Have a steak that is absolutely perfectly cooked. Get somebody to clean for me, you'd have more time to enjoy cooking. Yeah. A cleaner is the big one. I fucking hate cleaning. I hate dusting. I hate... Dusting's the worst. I don't mind vacuuming, but I hate dusting. I hate polishing things. I hate fucking... Everything to do with that. It's just shit. I'm just paying someone for, like, you just kind of just dust this whole ass. That'd be great. That'd be the dream. The short-term dopamine of hitting add to cart. Oh, what did I fucking... What have I done, like, semi-recently that I've done? Oh. That monitor. This monitor I bought. About a month ago. That was exactly like that. I was like, oh, I can afford one, but... It will be pushing it a little bit. And as soon as I added it to cart and bought it, I was like, oh, yeah. New monitor. Woo! I've actually got off quite lucky with that. So, don't ask why, because I have shit everywhere in my fucking room. I've got a tax return form down here from the last one that was done. So I knew what I owed. I had to pay something in January. And I knew what I'd owed. And I was like, okay, I can afford to pay that one. That's no problem. We're chill for a few months, right? But I went to pay it last night. And I looked at the fucking date. And I was like, oh, fuck. This is last year's tax return. Why the fuck is that there? So I looked at the date and was like, shit, this is not what I expected. And I had to find the new one, or the this year's one. Found this year's one. Luckily, it was more, but luckily, it was still well within what I could afford to pay. And so I managed to pay it, but I got the dates mixed up and I'd expected to pay a certain amount that I was actually paying almost double. But luckily we could cover it. It was all right. But there was a moment of shit. You need an accountant? I have an accountant. I honestly, my accountants are fucking expensive, but she's worth every penny. When she comes to me, I'm not going to show these documents on stream, but she comes to me with a fucking massive wadge of paper of all these numbers and calculations and all this shit. Oh my God, I'd be in prison. I'd actually be in prison. I wouldn't have a clue where to start or how to do it. And she does all the expenses out nicely. She does like income from different areas, adds it all up, does all these fucking calculations and shit. Tax write-offs, expenses, like it's just, there's so much to it. I wouldn't have a Scooby's what I was doing. Not a Scooby's. She's worth every single penny. And I won't go to prison. Which is always good. And I've said this before on stream. It is so easy. It would be so easy. Not is, because I've never done it. But it would be so easy to not pay a penny of tax as a streamer. So easy. Stupidly easy. And I guarantee there's a lot of streamers that are absolutely fucked because they haven't. And one day when the government catches on and starts auditing these people, I think there's going to be a lot of people going to prison. Because it's so easy to not pay tax. I mean, I don't know about America, but in the UK, like, I could easily get away with doing this as a job, just not paying a penny. Easily. But, as I say, is it worth fucking the tax man knocking on my door going, hey, are you working? And then you're absolutely screwed. Um, I done my version of year end to compare against my accountant's version to see if he was worth the money. It saved me $5,000 on your tax bill. That's what I mean. Like, they are expensive, but they save you money in ways that you would never be able to do yourself. So it sort of covers the cost. In that case, more than covers the cost. Well worth £1,000 you paid him, exactly. Oh, you're absolutely spot on. Imagine the hundreds of millions that I save from my stream of billions, yes. Yes. Hundreds of billions of dollars. I think we have white concrete already. A large part of this bottom bit is just light gray, so we should be alright for a sec. Offshore accounts in Switzerland and the Canary Islands and shit like that. I have been meaning to ask my accountant if it's literally that simple. Like, could I just move my business to Dubai somehow and then just not pay any tax because there's zero income tax there? But I imagine if it was that easy, everybody would do it. So you probably need like a fucking citizenship or have to spend X amount of months of the year in the country or something like that. His home office was bigger than your entire house. You guys need to give love to accountants next time a client pisses me off. A client pisses you off? Need to be there for 6 months of the year? That'd be crazy. That'd be absolutely crazy. I believe then you pay taxes in both countries. Nah, you definitely don't pay in both countries. That'd be stupid. That'd be stupid. I think you pay taxes in the one that you're a resident in. Or you claim to be a resident. Adam has returned, everybody. Adam has returned. Hello, Adam. God, you imagine there's a double tax treaty? Fuck that. That'd be crazy. You can have dual citizenship, that's very true. But I think you still have the country that you reside in, right? That's like your main one, and that's where you pay the tax. Look who it is, it's Adam! I'll tell you what I found crazy yesterday. I learned something yesterday. And that is that 25% of all US tax income, like everything that the government gets, the entire income of it, goes to paying off the interest on the debt of the country. That is fucking mental. That is ridiculous. Like, and that's only going to get worse. Like, that's mental. Oh, thank you for the Pedro. We're not going to get political here, chat, by the way. But the debt increases still. Yeah, it's just a massive fucking snowball effect. So, something that needs to change. And without getting political here, but Elon reckons he can cut government spending because there's so much waste by $2 trillion, which will help. But how the fuck you get out of that is, I don't know. But it's something that needs to be figured out and figured out relatively fast before the country goes bankrupt. He'll probably pay it off himself. I don't think Elon Musk has $35 trillion. I don't think he has $35 trillion. He has a lot of money, but not $35 trillion. Crazy thing is, I remember when I was starting in the investing realm that people were talking about the US debt problem. And at the time, I think you were like $21 billion in debt or something. And now it's up to 35. Like, oh my days, it's going up fast. And it's just going to be a big old snowball. A big old snowball. As the interest gets higher, as the debt goes up, more interest, more interest. And if it gets to 100% of taxpayer money's paying interest, the company's bust, the country's bust. Broke. Crazy. England, England, England. I don't know if the pound is debt, actually. I'm not sure. Because I only really deal most things in US dollars. Talking about certain tax and debts, update on the absolute cretin at the missus' work. She reported him for sexual harassment and they let him go immediately. Way! Good. Good. Good riddance. I know the pound's worth more than the dollar, but I don't know if the pound is still debt. I'm not sure. I'm now curious. Is the pound debt? Oh, it is debt. Shit. 2.7 trillion. That's crazy. That is crazy. Yeah, the pound's been worth more for ages, but I was curious how much debt it's in. Oh! Party time! Getting a KFC after stream. No, I'm not. Jack, don't fucking joke about that, because you're going to want one now. Now you've told yourself mentally that you're going to be having a KFC. Fuck. Now I've got excited for something that I'm not actually going to have. But maybe I should have it now to cleanse the fact that I want it. Chippy tonight. Is that what we're going to have? We're going to have fish and chips. Ugh, fine by me. What are those? That's Tangier. If you click on the extension below the stream or you hover over the screen or exclamation mark Tangier in chat, there's a bunch of effects that you can use and have fun with on the screen. It's great. It's good fun. You can ask AI people questions and they'll answer them. Like, some of them can be very funny. But there's all sorts. Thousands and thousands and thousands.
Customization.
Genius.
He's tenderizing the ground.
Of course.
Write that down. Write that down.
Like that. United! Hey! Guy Bird! What a legend. What a legend. My guy! United, baby. Hold on, I've got my scarf here, Guy Bird. One second. I've got my beanie and scarf.
Feast mode activated. Hashtag hungry.
You liked it. Oh, yeah. Woo. You and I. TD. You liked it. Oh, the team for me with a nick. That paddywhack, give the dog a bone. Why don't City fuck your form? Oh, I see. Happy days. I didn't know you were a United fan, Guy Bird. What a legend.
What the hell is even that?
Thank you, John. Never, Tulpo. Never. This is greatness, what you see here. I did see that, Speedy. I did see that. Damn it, I need to fold my scarf up. Look what's happened. Balls. Okay. Honestly, I'm American, so sadly, I'm an idiot and don't know anything about the team or sport. That doesn't matter, Guy Bird. You're not an idiot. You're smart enough to know that United is the way to go, my friends. So, regardless of how much
if
you know about the team or sport...
If I find one of these lying around again, I swear to God, I will stop being so polite. Get the out of my sight before I demolish you.
You made a good decision, Guy Bird. Thank you, Tulpo. You made a good decision... United. Whoa! Holy fucking shit! Boom! Guy Bird coming in with a 50 bomb! What the fuck? Shit! Thank you very much, mate. Oh my god. Well, that's a glowing red sign in the pagodas. You're going in the world, Guy Bird. Thank you very much, mate. What a legend. You'll be going in one of these. Where's the red one? This is the red one. You'll be going in the red pagoda, sir. Thank you, mate. Oh, fuck me. That's absolutely crazy. We get a huge wall of hearts up, my man, Guy Bird. I'd appreciate it. Don giving him a sub as well. Thank you very much, Don.
Wow.
Oh, is there not a hype train available? Oh no! When did the hype train finish? The hype train is available in 5 minutes. No! God damn it! Oh, that'd have been a prime opportunity to beat our own train. God damn it! The hype train's available in 5 minutes. Ah, oh, that would have been so good if we could have had that bomb on a hype train. We need to win this month to win, or to be able to tie with Matt. So we have to come up with some big-ass train that he can't beat. You're almost at 750. Are you, Guy Bird? Holy crap, mate. What a legend. Thank you, pal. I don't even know if I can get to the top of that. Oh, I can. 723. That is absolutely bonkers, mate. Thank you very, very much. What a legend. I'm hoping we can get all of this text done today. We should be okay. Guy!
Wow.
Holy fucking shit. What are you doing, man? God. With another 50. This is so depressing that there's no hype train available right now. So depressing. Mate, you're fucking crazy, Guy Bird. Thank you very much. Dear Lord. I've got 4 minutes until a hype train's available. No! That'd have been 100 subs on a hype train, man. That'd have been massive. That'd have been massive.
Oh, yeah.
3 minutes until that trade's available. Guyber, thank you very much, pal. You're a fucking legend, mate. What on earth? Chat, we're not continuing this show until we get a huge wall of hearts in the channel of my man, Guyber. What a legend. Adam, thank you for the Kool-Aid, man. Appreciate that. Can't thank you enough, Guyber. You've no idea how much it helps me out, bud. Thank you. Dear Lord. Whoops. I don't know if I... Last time I was available for your stream, we broke the first sub trade record maybe a year ago. Then I popped in and you told it got beaten. Wait, what do you mean, guy, bud? Last time I was available in your stream, we broke the first... We did break the trade record. Yeah, we did. You gifted something crazy, like 400 or 500 subs. Yeah. Yeah, you did. It was crazy. That was actually like 3 years ago, by the way. That was building the gold farm... of season two. Oh, no, maybe 2 years ago. Maybe that was 2 years ago. And then in March, we got the... Yeah, March, we beat it and got to level 26 somehow, which is just bananas. Oh, it's got to be the powder, Georgia. Yeah, mate. Crazy guy, man. Crazy, mate. Adam, thank you for the spray stream. Appreciate it, mate. I need a drink. Oh, man. Crazy. Time flies. It feels like 6 months ago. It does. It really does. Why does Twitch have cooldowns on hype trains? I don't know. Maybe to retain the hype sort of aspect of it, but I do agree. I wish there wasn't cooldowns. Although the hype train should now be available. I believe it's now available. I don't think... God... I don't think Guybird's 50 will still count though if it started, because that was only 3 minutes ago. The marathon stream, 18-hour marathon, is next Friday. Friday the 15th, starting at 6 a.m. UK time, which is 7 hours ago. Wait, it didn't count. No, it won't count towards the train because the train wasn't ready. So, because we had a train 55 minutes ago and you have to wait an hour for it to become available again. So, those 100 subs, unfortunately, won't add to the trade. Damn it, Sonic. I think it will count the last 5 minutes. I don't know. We're one off our hype train, though. There it is. You can see it at the top of the screen. Are you kidding me? I know, Guybird. I know. That's why I was like, no! That's why I was gutted. Because that would have been a massive trade. Oh, thank you for the tournament. We'll see if it has added the last 50. It would count now, yeah, now that the train's available. It's because the cooldown was still going. Let's see. Did it add the last 50? I don't think it will have. No. It's so depressing, man. God. Oh, my God.
Wow.
Guyman, what the fuck? Yeah, that one might have counted. Holy fucking shit. Mate, you're absolutely insane. Level, we just went straight to level 11. Oh my god. Yeah, that counted, Gowan. Shit in it, mate. Thank you very, very much. Well, that'll be a gold side. That'll be a, we were literally saying about how, like, a very few and far between, but we'll have to come up with what we're going to do, because I can't even speak.
Hey, chat. Fuck. 1, 2, 3.
Level. Shit in it, man. What the fuck?
And his name is
I'm actually shaking. Crazy. Absolutely crazy. Rubber Duck, thank you so much, mate. I appreciate it. We're getting you on the in the green pagoda, pal. Taking us to level 12. Thank you very much. Oh man. Wait, I'm not subbed anymore. What the fuck? Yeah, you are somebody. Don gifted you a sub. Don gifted you one. Mate, you're fucking crazy, man. Chat, can we get a huge wall of hearts? All the guys dropping love. And Guy Bird going absolutely crazy, man. What a fucking legend. Thank you. It does, but 100 subs is the max you can do. You can't do any more than that. I've completely... My brain's fried. What on earth are we doing? I think I needed this. Absolutely bananas. If you did get a gifted sub, congratulations. My word. We're up to 781 subs. Mental. Absolutely mental. Well, we now have an opportunity here to guarantee a win for the month. Depending on how high we can get this train. We've done all the hard part. And now we're just pushing this train as high as possible. So that Matt can't beat it this month. And that we will be victorious.
Victorious!
I had a good streak. I forgot to change my card on Twitch. You changed back. No! Oh, it's all good, Guy. No, it's all good. It still saves your total amount of months. It still saves that. Great. Marcus, 28 months. Thank you so much, mate. Welcome back.
Feels okay, man.
28 months, mate. Really do appreciate it. Level 12 on the train. 3 minutes to go. It needs 22 subs or 11,000 bits to beat level 12. My God. My God. That's quite a lot. That is quite a lot. The train might be a ripperoo here, boys. You never know. We may be able to chip away at it. Every bit helps. Like Nightwolf with 100 bits.
Bullets.
Like I'm freeloading. Georgia, thank you for the 300 biddies. Really do appreciate that. Thank you, thank you, thank you. 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go. To hopefully bury Matt, although his community have a bit of a reputation for beating us the very next day on the train. We can't allow that to happen. As I say, if Matt wins this month, we lose the competition that's gone on the entire year. So we have to win. We have to win. Somehow. Don with a 5 gifted. Wow. Thank you, Don. Really do appreciate that. Let's get you a sign in the pagodas. Thank you, Don. It continues. Takes out a nice little chunk there. We've only got a minute and 30 seconds to go, though, to find 8,100 bits or 17 subs to take us to level 13. Only a minute and 20 seconds to go. It might be over. It might be over. But you never know. If you have a Prime sub chat, take a look. It's completely free to use. It'll help us on the train. Every percent counts.
Did I jump scare you?
Yes, you did.
Yeah,
fuck's
I bet
sake.
I did.
Fuck's sake. Thank you, Kirion. Damn it. 50 seconds left, boys. I think this is the end of the train. 50 seconds left. Dear Lord. Dear Lord. remove that Tangier. We may up the price of it, maybe. 30 seconds, boys. I think that could be over. Salute it. Salute it. Level 12, 43%. Is beatable. I feel like Matt could beat that. His community are absolutely crazy. But it's higher than level 10, which is good. Thank you very, very, very much for the support. 10 seconds, boys. Salute the train. It is out of here. Dear Lord. Can you imagine if Guy Bird's first 250 bombs were on that as well? Mad. Mad. Well, there he goes.
Bullseye!
No!
Wow.
Would that have saved it? It would have as well. No! No! Guyver, thank you very much, mate. Fucking hell. You're crazy. I can't even type your name on here. You're getting four glowing red signs in the stadium, in the pagodas. Oh, man! Twitch, you suck! Final thing for that was level 12, 44%. I don't know what... I need to message Imp, make sure he's okay, because I've not seen him in the last couple of days. Usually helps if I can type. Oh, it's already done. He's here. He's here. My word. Thank you all very much for the support, chat. We got a wall of hearts for everybody chucking love on that train. I would appreciate it. Thank you all very much. Crazy. I actually feel lightheaded. Bonkers. Bananas. In pajamas. Oh, no. I've gone wrong here. Black. Yeah, I've gone wrong. Good job I noticed that now. Can you save all my points for a fucking annoying parrot name tag and put that shit somewhere random? You want a parrot in the world. That could be arranged. That could be arranged. We have a jungle right next to us. Guy Bird for a reason. Well, that's very true. That is very true. Very fitting. Dear Lord. I've completely lost my head. Like, my brain is frazzled. Stick the parrot on top of the pagoda. I don't know if I could get it to follow me up there. Because, I don't know. Maybe I could. We'll have a little look after this. We'll try it. Let me quickly finish this up. Oh, God. It should teleport to me. Yeah, it should do. Peach. What the fuck was that? Peach the stream. Thank you, Dove. Oops. Nope. Here we go. Right, let me quickly finish this, see if I can build it all up. And then we'll go get Guy Bird's parrot. Get it named up. I think so, Georgie. Yeah, but parrots, they'll sit on your shoulder, but not if you use an Elytra. Tangier has turned me into a nervous wreck. It's okay. It's okay. No. No. Fine, are you some friggin' Minecraft noob, bro? Come on, man. Come on, bro. You've never gotten an Elytra yet. That should be your goal on your server. Get yourself an Elytra. Well, the name tag would be Guy Bird's name. Guy Bird, are you happy with going on top of the red pagoda? Or would you rather be somewhere more noticeable? I'm a Minecraft noob. There's nothing wrong with that. Put a stupid bird wherever you'd like. Alright, mate. I got you. We are going to do something other than a bird. Don't worry. We'll be... We've got to come up with what we're going to do, because... Well, believe it or not... Gold tier signs don't happen very often. Red Ronnie, let's get you in the pagoda. Thank you, mate. Yeah, gold tier signs don't happen very often. We need more concrete. God damn it. I need more white. Let's just carry on with what we've got. We'll see what we can do. Like, I don't know what we could... I don't even know. Oh, we don't have that as well. Make him follow you forever. What if it gets blown up? You are forever there, Nightwolf, as king of the pond. True. That is true. That is very true. Surprised you haven't bought it back. We have. It's just not promoted that much. King of the Pond is still available. If somebody drops 5,000 bits, we will go and get them a fish. And they will be King of the Pond. And that's fine. And they will be there until somebody else dethrones them. Happily. But you have to request it when you do the cheer. A little bird cage outside the castle. We can do that, man. That is how we've always done it, Smitty. What happens to the old king? Well, so the way it works is you have a king of the pond. They say 5,000 bits. Say, I want to be the king of the pond. Put the fish in there named after them. And then if somebody else does 5,000 bits and says, I want to be king / queen of the pond, then there's a 10-minute timer that starts to save the previous king of the pond. Who can either save himself or somebody else can save him within that 10 minutes. And if the 10-minute timer expires, because people start fighting over who can be the king, if the 10-minute timer expires, that person is now the king. And either the old one gets killed, replaced, or remains, depending on if it's saved or not. Right, I need a parrot. How do you tame a parrot? I think it's seeds. I believe it's seeds. I've got to find one. How hard can this be, honestly? It's a parrot. It should be everywhere. Mr. Parrot! Hello! Parrots! Any parrots? Any parrots around? Anybody seeing any parrots? There's a jungle temple over there, I can see. I don't know if we've been to that. Any parrots? Any parrots? This is a very parrotless jungle. Yeah, now I've said how hard could it be, and I will never find one. I will never get over how I recklessly deleted 600 pounds in a King of the Pond fight to kill Mason 3.5 years ago. Well, as you said earlier, Nightwolf, you like the euphoria of it. Wasn't that against Simon? I think Simon was on Mason's side. I do remember that. Walk on ground level. But they spawn everywhere, in trees and all sorts. Oh my god. I didn't really want to render much over here, but there's going to be a warden place down there. Game, can you just give me a fucking parrot? This sucks, man. This was meant to be a quick grab a bird and get out, and now it's turning out to be rather complicated. Oh my god. I know! I thought parrots were fairly common. Evidently, I was wrong. What the hell? For God's sake. The problem is now I can't quit. I've got to keep going until I find one. The good news is, I do have a second jungle biome we can go to if this one goes to pot. Ding ding! I think they respawn. I don't think there's a set amount. I'm not entirely sure. Hello, Jen. How are we? Parrot! I found a parrot! Hello! Oh, there's another one! Right. You. Fucking greedy piece of shit. Right. I need more seeds. Eight. That has to be enough. Nine. Parrot, get your ass here right now. Right. Oh, that was convenient, wasn't it? That was easy. Are you now going to follow me? Oh, God. How do I get it on my shoulder? Oh. Hey! What? Stupid ass, but this is going to be a nightmare. What are you doing? Is he going to teleport to me? Let's find out. Oh, he will. Okay, good. Keep up, bird. You saw what happened to the other guy. No, he didn't. He didn't see shit. It'll be fine. Come on. Thank you. Okay, I'm just going to keep running. Don't get lost. Good boy. Oh, we're so far away from the base. Come on. Swear to God, if I find a parrot right over here, I'm going to be livid. Oh my God. Fuck's sake. Of course. Of course you're here. Oh, there he is. Blue one's pretty. Leave Guy Bird alone. What are you doing? Get over here. Thank you. Thank you. Right, keep up, please. Oh, the TNT looks so sick. Water is hard for them, apparently. Where is he? Oh, there he is. Keep up now. Keep up. Come up. Steady on now. You are taking the piss. I've just traipsed 1,000 blocks over there, and there was a dude right here the whole time. Typical. No, flying doesn't work. It's the same with wolves, Speedy. If you get too far away from like a block, they just stay where they are. Come on. Keep up now. Almost there. What do you need a parrot for? It's for Guybird. Guybird decided to go crazy and drop like fucking 200 subs. And has requested a parrot in the world. And for 200 subs, you can have whatever you want in the world. Get over here. Right. You can, Jada, yeah, but you just seem to jump off. I'm not going to get on my shoulder again. Oh, there we go. Oh, that was easy. Now, what happens if I fly? Oh my god, he's still on my shoulder! He's still there! Oh, he's fallen off! Shit! Come here, bud. I'm assuming he's still there. Oh, he's fallen off again. Stupid ass parrot. Thank you. Yeah, Guybird did 50-50, 100, and then 20. Absolutely bananas. Absolutely bananas. Unfortunately, the hype train had like 3 minutes left or whatever on its cooldown. So the first lots of 250 never counted on the trade. Which that would have been... it would have been a monstrous trade, man. That would have hopefully secured the win for the month. Right, I need iron bars. Yeah, and the 20 as well, yeah. Devastating stuff. Do I have any? Hold on. Oh, it's all good, guy, by the way. It's all good, man. You're still crazy. It's still greatly appreciated. This is just full of shit. What the hell? Yeah, there's a 1 hour cooldown at the end of every train. Kind of annoying. There's not much you can do about it, unfortunately. But we are in the lead. In fact, we extended our lead, which is good. Level 12 is very beatable. Matt's community have multiple times hit 15, 16. So, we're going to have to hope it's enough, but... Come on. Wow, he's actually sort of keeping up with that. Button build an aquarium in the storage system. a lot. We don't want to just leave you out the base, Kaiba. Let's put you actually in this base. Right. How about somewhere like here? Nice open area. Quiet, bird. In the cage. Come on. I don't want to go in the cage. You're going in the cage. Get over here. Come up. Land. Shit. Come up. Land. Not on me, you muppet. Get in here. Get off. Sit. Come a bit further forward. No! Too much. Sit. You'd rather be in this little bird cage. Let's get you right in the middle of that ship. I need a name tag. Oh, they should be over there. I need a name tag and a jukebox. Do I have one of the name tags? Oh, I do. 10 parts will not despawn though. Name tag. And jukebox. How do I make a jukebox? I have no idea. I thought you meant turn this whole bottom bit into an aquarium. How the hell do you make a jukebox, chat? Eight planks and a diamond. Well, we have the diamond. No, he's still gonna... Guybird's still gonna get a, some sort of golden... I don't know how we're gonna do it in this world. We haven't figured it out. But he's gonna get more than this. He just wanted this in the world. So I was like, yeah, you can have that as well. Why not? He's still going to get his golden thing in the pagodas. How are we going to do it again? Like I said, I don't know. I'm not quite sure, but we'll figure it out. Might let me sleep. There's monsters nearby. What do you mean? I'll sleep out here then. I also deserve one seed per day. Now we're pushing it. You think we have that kind of budget, guy? But Jesus, man. Actually, to be fair, this is actually a bit cruel. Why is he outside? Let's get him inside. Even with a 25% Christmas discount, United Liverpool kits with... with your own name on, still over £100. Crazy. Luckily, I get member discounts. Here, get on. Let's go. Come in here, please. Don't put me in a fucking one by one. What's wrong with the one by one? I'll put you in this fucking corner right here. Right. Come here. Mate, are you on me? Get off. Something's on fire. What's on fire? Hold on, chat. Parcel at the door. 1 second. Damn it, headphones. Did I just kill you? No, I didn't. You're on my shoulder again, I think. Yeah, you are. Bird, I need you to stop being a pain. Here, go in here. Right. Sit. Good. Back, back. There you go. Now you've got your own little bird cage. All birds love a bird cage. Definitely looks a little bit like a prison, but it definitely looks a little bit like a prison. But ah, fuck this. Better idea. Better idea. Get up on my shoulder. Let's go. Sit. You're now forever gonna live up here. Aren't they a bit false? This is Guy Bird's parrot. We've gone from caging outside to caging inside to roaming free in my house. There you are, Guy Bird. We thank you for the support. Again, you're crazy. Right. No, oh shit! I didn't mean to do that! Sorry! Sorry! Have a seed. Bollocks. Bro! Steady. You don't fucking listen, do you? Get on! Bro! You're being a pain in the ass here, parrot. This is why no one likes fucking birds. They're so annoying. Get over it. Oh, I should have just left him. Get on the box! I'm sorry I punched you. I didn't mean to do that. Look at him looking at me. Mocking me. Yeah, that's what I thought. You better fly over here. Fast. Get up here. Thank you. I just wish you'd come a little bit further forward rather than sit so far back, but it's fine. Stay there then. I need a CD. I have a CD. I'm chilling. Quit beating me. I'm breaking my base, Liam. Fucking Liam, man. I'm going to destroy my own base. This guy. I must have a disc in here, surely. That'll do. Is this DMCA-able? I don't know. I don't even know what that one is. Suck it all up.
Adam 02265 cent. Why did we need a parrot?
Wait, jingle singing TTS. Thank you, Adam. I appreciate the jingle singing TTS. Are you gonna dance? Hey! Oh yeah! Oh! It's enough dancing. Before I get DMCA'd. You gotta sit there and look pretty, guy, man. That's what you're gonna do, man. I don't know if I've ever made a parrot dance in Minecraft, so that might be a world first for me. Right, well, now Guybird's back in the base. We will get him something as like a gold, some sort of gold thing. I don't know how we're going to do it yet. I didn't plan for that to happen, so unless we put him at the tippity top. Maybe we turn the top of the red one into the gold room. I don't know. Maybe something, I don't know. I'll have to do something like that. This is coming along nicely. I just need more concrete. Wait till next time, Amir. We're getting a fucking frog, mate. Ribbit. Theory, me. That's a done deal. I will go out of my way to get you a frog. Happily, if chaos like that assumes again. From anybody, that is. Right, give me... Tempted to gift some so you'll finally get a bunny. No! No! You're not gifted anything. I will... If you give a single sub, Steph, I won't come over today. How about that? How about that? You can't do that. Yes, I can. I just... Right, we need a shitload of white concrete. Let's have a look. It might be worth... I was going to say using some of the poppies to make bone meal, but... I missed out on hype train, so Matt won't call it cheating. It's not cheating, it's okay. God, I'm absolutely knackered. Right. I need... bone meal over here. I need to be punctual tonight. Punctual? What do you mean? Hello! Apparently we're having dinner at a parent's, so I've got to be on my best behavior. Barn, how much are you to get a sniffer and in the pen put bits of string on the ground around it? Why would I put string? The answer now is 100,000 bits. How's that? Or 200 subs. The same as Guy. That way, I'll never have to do it, and I can just carry on playing my game. Right. Hi, AMZ, how are you? Thousand bits for a sniffer. The stupidest mob in the game. Nightwolf is trying to make a very what's the word for it? A very Gen Z humor joke of using the string as cocaine and having a sniffer continuously sniff lines of string. Yeah. That was what he was getting at. with Night Wars Gen. It's probably Gen Alpha humor. Actually, Gen Z is probably being nice. See the Elon's rip button. I know. I'm going to be judged because I've not seen them since June. Not like intentionally, just things just haven't lined up that way. So I'm going to be judged. They're going to think I'm not good enough for Steph. Then they're going to encourage her to leave me. And then it'll be a 24-hour sad stream. I don't know what it was. It was a long time ago. Long, long time ago. It was probably March, actually. I can still remember how that music used to make me smile. What a song. It was my birthday! Jesus, God. I mean, be shouting that. Oh, it was May then, okay. I'm being shouted at, Dad. God, I've been glue ad and everything. Please don't drop 100k in one go. I still haven't added it back to the cup. Alex! For God's sake! We've master prestige that bar 3 times! And there's been no animation. We had a 100k bomb dropped, and there was no enormous 100k bit in the cup. It's a disaster. Hello, Imp. I was gonna message you and see how you were, but you're all gravy. Why am I here? I need to get out of here. Now Steph's annoyed at me. Our whole fucking anniversary weekend is now ruined. Brilliant. Hi, by the way, Alex. Hope you're doing well, man. I've been doing overtime today. Possibly a little bit, yeah, but I've got Arnold today, so I've got to be a bit careful. New schedule starts next week of Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday being earlier starts. Somewhere between 9 and 10 a.m. rather than 11 a.m. because I won't... because I won't have Arnold on those days anymore, which is good. Thursday, Friday, I still will, so that'll be 11 a.m. start. And what else was I going to say? But next week, it might not be Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, because we have the marathon, so someone's going to have him on Friday. So it'll probably be a case of I'll have to have him on, like, a Monday or the Tuesday. Sort of balance it out a little bit. Consumed by work these days. Very hardworking man, Alex. Hey, Kazi, welcome back, mate. I remember you. Don't panic. I remember you. Better, 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 better. Not some infant because of my birth. You are always going to be a baby to me, Alex. All right, you're always going to be a baby. I'm an old man. Right, I'm pushing 26 now. I'm getting on. And you'll always be younger than me. So based on that, you'll always be a child, and that's okay. But that doesn't mean you cannot be a young man. Shut the hell up. I'm over 40. Yeah, but when you get to 30, you stop caring. I'm not at that point yet. 26 is, like, still pretty rough. I need to go to Boots. Text me if you need anything. Yeah, I don't need anything, I don't think. I don't think so. Yes, you will, Alex. Yes. What's going to happen is my health's already terrible, so I'm going to die by, like, 50, right? I'll be dead. And Alex is going to wait a couple years and sharpen my grave and be like, ha! I'm older than you now, boy. I'm older than you now, mate. Now call me a child. Steph, can you come back with a better attitude? Wow! Liam, you're fucking with a force you don't want to mess with. What did I do? I don't know, but Liam's starting to fight over it. I mean, morbidly hilarious, but also so sad. Chat, that is so sad. Standard reply whenever my missus goes to the shop and asks me if I want anything. And you say, can you come back with a better attitude? Oh my god. Wow. How are you alive? We'll go slightly over time. I can't do too much though, because I've got dog. I'm on dog duty. Like in the doghouse again. I'm not in the doghouse. Liam is. I'm chilling, man. I'm cushy. I am cushy. I'm also fucking freezing. It is cold, but this is like streaming weather, man. It's good. That bar is asking to be rounded up. What bars? What is this weekend? Sports bars? What do you mean rounded up? Oh, the bit bar! Oh shit! Look at that! Whoa, I didn't even notice that. We are 87 bits away. That took me way too long to math. 87 bits away from a second prestige. My word. It's... Adam, thank you for the 100 red. Thank you, mate. Better, 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 better. There we are. Yeah, true, true. Reminds me of that, the guy in the drive-thru. Sorry, sir, we're closed. No, you're not. Get that fucking cougar on.
4,000 bits. 4,500 bits. 4,999 bits.
Jed! Thank you for the meme. Appreciate it. Panic! Thank you, Jed. God, I love a good old meme. We're getting there. Slowly but surely. Hi, Cruise Screedo. Good to see you, mate. Screws. I'm just going to say screws. It's fucking easier. I'll give up with the Credo shit. I keep getting it wrong. Screws. Oh, wait, mate. That song was in my head now, and Pedro is going to hate me. Nightwolf is just a shit bloke. God damn it, man! Fucking Nightwolf with his falling pipe. We're gonna up that to 500 bits, by the way. This close to unsubbing. Pedro, no! Don't unsub, man. It's all good. That falling pipe one is getting up. It's going up to 500 bits. per pipe. I'm not I'm not responsible for this. I'm not responsible. Maybe we should up the price of Pedro as well. Just for Pedro's sake. You enabled the extension, so you are responsible. I didn't know it was going to be abused. How was I supposed to know it was going to be abused? Yes, you did. No, I didn't. I've just said I will up the price. How about that? I'll up the price by 50 bits. I remember when you told me you didn't like distractions on the screen. Clearly, that was a lie. Well, that was before the future of the stream was in jeopardy, Alex. To be fair, it's not permanently on the screen. And it is just a random little meme that pops up. It could be a laugh. But it was either find a way to help promote bits and things like that. Because the streak was getting closer and closer. It was always in panic action stations. It was getting closer and closer and closer to being lost. And so we were like, right, we need to come up with something so we can continue. Because otherwise I'm out of a full-time job of streaming by the new year. So I was like, we need to find something to help promote that. And Tangier is that. So, I prefer to have a clean screen, but we can have a bit of a laugh with this. Thank you, Wes. The bits don't add to the bar, no. Apparently that's to do with Twitch, though, not Supercross Tools.
Adam, Joe222695 asked me, why is Button such a noob in this day and age? Ah, like cooking an overcooked piece of steak. It's all about not learning from past mistakes. You take a noob, sprinkle a dash of ignorance, a teaspoon of hesitation, and a whole cup of not paying attention. Mix it all up with a lack of practice and failure to adapt. And voila, you've got a classic newbie recipe. It's like they've never been near a competent kitchen in their life. Bloody hell.
Adam, thank you for the 200 bits. Guy of Earth redeeming an on-screen celebration. Thank you, mate. Thank you, Adam. Oh, dear. I did tell you that some of the AI ask a question is rather funny. I did tell Jack this. Hey, Dice, how are you? That was funny. Right. Finish up this layer. Happy days. We're now in overtime as well, boys. Pog. I'm good. New computer, so I'm living it up. Oh, I'm jealous, man. That's fucking awesome. Can't beat a new computer. These new Ryzen chips have come out now, and I'm like, I really want to build a new PC. Lola's going to be 4 years old in January. And usually every 3 to 5 years, I put the gaming PC as the streaming PC and build a new gaming PC. Because the streaming PC is like 7 years old. Due an upgrade. So we're going to go balls to the walls, though, with this next PC. I've just bought this 4K 144Hz monitor. And we want to be able to push games at that sort of speed. And in order to do that, we're going to need a lot of power. So we're thinking...
What
Sniffer inbound.
Oh my god. And there's no hype train available. Diamond! What the fuck? Oh my god. Holy fucking shit. I don't think there's... Mate, what the fuck is going on? Today has been bananas. The train is 9 minutes away from being available. Skybird, you are fucking mental, mate. You are absolutely crazy. I don't know what the train would have been from that, but Matt wouldn't have won this month. My god. What the fuck? I don't even know what to say, man. Guy Bird, you are absolutely crazy, mate. Thank you very, very much. I'm going to have to go and get a fucking sniffer. Oh my god. Brought fucking tears to my eyes. You have no idea how much that helps out a ton, mate. You have no idea. Thank you very, very much. Chat, can we get the most enormous wall of hearts hype and love in the channel for my man Guy Bird? I can't believe a train has not been available for that or the fucking first 100 subs you dropped, man. Oh my god. Oh, Jesus. I can actually tell you what level of train that would have been. Because Matt sent me the list of the requirements. Crazy. Surprise. Anyway, let me pull up this and see if I can tell you what that would have been. I need to pin this actually to our chat when I find it here. That was fishing. That was that. Ah, here it is. So that would have been an instant level 14 trade. Wow. Hey, Skybird, thank you so much, mate. I can't thank you enough, bub. You are absolutely mental. And I don't even know what to say. But I'm going to have to get you a sniffer. I will find one somewhere. I'm not gonna have time to do it today because I've got to look after the dog, but we will get you a sniffer on Monday. We're playing modded, so it'll be Tuesday's show. God, I'm actually like fucking shaking, man. Jesus Christ. Next time I do shit like that, I'm gonna ask on times because that's cooked. I know. Mate, honestly though, I mean I can't thank you enough for that. You're just crazy. Mental. I don't know if we have a sniffer egg. We had one in the last one. I'm going to have to go and use a paintbrush and start digging them up. Fucking hell, man. I've gotten lightheaded. I'm genuinely just not with it at all. all I can say is Matt is so lucky that what's happened today has not happened when a train's been available. Oh my word. Whew. Composure button, man. Come on.
The Druid Jen asked me, why is Guy B1RD the best? Are the enigmatic Guy B1RD a creature of the digital wild? With the endurance of a seasoned explorer, they navigate the treacherous waters of Twitch streams, much like a peregrine falcon soaring through the skies. Their dedication to watching every moment of the stream, despite the constraints of a grueling work schedule, showcases an unwavering passion that resonates with the community. It's this commitment and their unique personality that make Guy B1RD truly one of a kind.
Wow, that was amazing. That was absolutely amazing. Thank you, Jed. Appreciate that. That question there to Sir David Attenborough. Is Matt all good? Why did he end early? Is he all right? Thank you, guy. I appreciate it, man. But thank you, man. Everything went to shit. He's having a bad day. Oh god, I will message him after the stream and see if he's alright. What, like the stream, just like the internet or something, or computer problems, or server problems? It's Jen, it's the bit where it said, with the endurance of a seasoned explorer, they navigate the treacherous waters of Twitch streams. Their dedication to watching every moment of the stream despite the constraints of a grueling work schedule showcases an unwavering passion. That is just crazy. Server, MZ, sub. Oh dear, I see. Yeah, technical difficulties are a pain in the ass. Especially when they limit what you're able to do as like an actual stream. Fell out of a coconut tree. Oh dear. It's on Tangier. So if you load up, if you're on desktop, you can either do !! Tangier in the chat or click below the stream. There's this little pop out here. If you click on this, you can do ask AI. There's a bunch of you can ask Gordon Ramsay, Dr. Phil, Trump, Johnny, whoever that is, Richard Nixon, Chewbacca. There's all these different people. There's loads and loads of people here, and you can ask them questions, and they'll read it out. I think Jeremy Clarkson's on here somewhere. Jeremy Clarkson's on there. Shaq. Like, there's all sorts on here. I haven't set up Tangier Dungeons yet. No, I need to. I haven't had time to look more into it at the moment. Man, I need to fucking, like, sort myself out here. I'm so lightheaded from everything that's just happened. Crazy. I know this is part of the end. Did that count as a train? No. Guyver did 50 subs twice when he came in, and there wasn't a train available for like 2 minutes. And then there was a train available, and then he did 100, and we got to like level 12. And then he just did that madness, and the train had like 8 minutes left on the cooldown. So a lot of it just hasn't counted the trains, which is such a shame. I'm not live at all this weekend, Guybird. Me and Steph are celebrating our 1 year anniversary. It was last week, but we can't do it this week. We need to increase the price of that. Me and Steph are celebrating our 1 year anniversary, so we will. In your message, you put the question. Yeah. So we're celebrating our 1 year anniversary, so I'm not here this week. This weekend. But I will be back on Monday. 220 subs and 100,000 bits, and only 100 of the subs counted towards a trade. Makes you want to vomit. It is a shame, man. It is a shame. It's okay though, mate. We like, you know, the support is still just as meaningful. It's still crazy, man. Still crazy. Yeah, then the trade was about to die, and he tried to do 20 subs to save it, but then couldn't because the trade had just expired like a second later earlier. Been a bad day in terms of trade timings. Been a bad day. I'm trying to like control my brain. Like my head is just mush. It can't fathom what's going on today. Bananas. Like, it is very, very rare you see 100,000 bits. Ever. I'm glad we've got a fucking epic alert for it, but you don't see that every day. You know, that is very, very, very few and far between. I was going to hit the 20, then the 100k, but the 20 failed, and I forgot about the reset and set the 100k. Fuck! That would have been massive, man. That would have been like level fucking 20, and we would have won the month, no problemo. Damn. That is unfortunate. Fuck the trade. I mean, I agree. But we'd have beaten Matt this month, which we need to do because Matt's beaten us 6-4. Yeah, I remember that. I do remember that. That was crazy. Absolutely crazy. You've never seen the bit bar that high? I mean, that is pretty crazy, isn't it? Like a master, even a master prestige on the bit bar is just you just never see that. It's crazy. Absolutely bonkers. But you got to try and do shit like 3 minutes before the timer. Yeah. Mobile can be a bit of a pain like that. Well, he did it as lots of 10Ks, not just a single 100,000, so it wouldn't have made a difference. But Alex really needs to get that implemented. Oh yeah, it is cut off. I see that. Is this the bit bar? Nope. I don't know what that is I just grabbed. Where's the bit bar here? Bit bar. That'll do. I'll leave the streak there because I'll move it up. I'm glad I was here for it this time back in May. You saw it. I fucking hate Nightwolf. Oh, it was Menace. God damn it. Sorry, Nightwolf. My bad. Thank you, Menace. Nightwolf's now going to fucking have a go at me. Oh, it was tapped. Oh, God. Crazy. Craziness. I can't fathom what happened today. Poor Nightwolf. Usually it is him, to be fair. Like, this is looking awesome. That last one just needs to be finished. It's going to look great. We've got to light that up too. We'll find a way of doing that. Oh, dearie me. Unfortunately, chat, I am going to have to call the stream here. Operation Get Guy Bird a Sniffer is go on Tuesday.
Oh, no. Anyway.
The Sniffer search is going to be like just gameplay in area type luck, right? Yeah, it's all luck. It's just whether or not you get an egg. I don't know if Guybird's in the 100k club. Let's have a look. If not, we'll get him in. Where's the 100k club here? Here it is. Guy Bird, are you in here? I don't believe you are. Well, we're getting you in, boy. Where are you, 100k club? Here it is. Copy this. You got it right underneath Curiosity, Guy Bird. What the fuck? You got it right underneath Curiosity in the 100k club. And as always, chat, whenever somebody joins the 100k club, we do like to give an enormous wall of hearts in the channel to thank them for everything. There you are, Guy Bird. There you are, pal. We do like to give them a massive wall of hearts in the channel for everything. So if we could do that for Guy Bird right now, I'd greatly appreciate it. I do know how to do that, Nightwolf. I just did it. But, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to have to get out of here. Jen, thank you for that. Really appreciate it. I love each and every one of you very much. Thank you so much for hanging out. We've had a fucking crazy stream today. I'm not here over the weekend. Me and Steph are away celebrating our 1 year anniversary. But I will be back on Monday, bright and early. If you look at your clock, go back 4 hours and 19 minutes is when we'll be here. my brain's fried. I can't remember how to do an outro. Make sure you follow the Twitter. I always tweet when I go live. 18 hour marathon stream is on Friday, starting at 6 a.m. UK time. So 18 hour marathon. It's live on Friday. Come by for it. We're going to be playing a bunch of games. We're going to be giving away a bunch of shit. It's going to be great. Can't wait for it. So make sure you come by for that. But be sure to follow the Twitter. I always tweet when I go live. Instagram if you're interested in my personal life. YouTube for the extra content. TikTok for more short form stuff. We posted something on there yesterday. Yeah, Friday coming. Is it 18 hour marathon? Thank you, cop. And then the VODs channel for anything you may have missed. It's the best way to watch all that as well. But ladies and gentlemen, have a beautiful rest of your day. Thank you so much for hanging out and the unbelievable support today. You guys are absolutely crazy. Smeegee going nuts earlier. Guy Bird as well. Like rubber duck in there, throwing a ton. Just so much. Dom with the subs. Crazy. Thank you all very, very much. Everybody. I cannot thank you all enough. But I will see you all live again on Monday. That is a crazy looking cup. Remember what that looks like. You don't see that very often. And I will see you all live then. I don't know if anybody's live to raid. In fact, we're not going to do a raid. I'm just going to say, please go out there into the world of Twitch, find somebody with one viewer and go say hello to them. So I guarantee it will make their day. But we will see you all back here on Monday. Stay safe, stay awesome. And until then, much love. Spam the channel of hearts on your way out. Show the love for this epic community. And we'll see you back here on Monday. Take care, everybody. Peace out, chat. Bye, everyone. See you all on Monday.